Welcome. This is my office. This is where most of the GeoMOOC was created. This is my first big feedback after the first week of the MOOC. It has been a very intense week. I was very happy with the response which you gave, the posts and the emails and so on. So that's really great, and I'm looking forward to continuing this MOOC. I want to give you in this feedback 3 points which have been either addressed during the week, or I think that they are very important. The first point is accommodation space. We have defined accommodation space as the vertical dimension of the space where you can deposit sediments. And we said that the most normal one, the typical one, is the space between the sea level and the sea floor. And we said that if this is, for instance, 10 meters, then if this does not change, then sediments will arrive, and then we will deposit these sediments, and then once the accommodation space is filled, then the story is finished. So we can accommodate a maximum of sediment thickness, which is comparable to accommodation space. This is much too little. So we need two ways. We have two ways to increase the accommodation space. One is to raise sea level, and this is what happens when we have interglacial times. But this is not very much, it can be maximum 100 or 200 meters. Or, and this is what happens, is to bring down this bottom surface with tectonic process by which we increase by large amounts the accommodation space. The second issue which I want to mention, which corresponds to block two, is that of the definition of the lithosphere. We've seen it above the core mantle boundary, seismic velocity decrease, and at a certain moment, arrive in a depth of about 200 kilometers, there is a low velocity zone. And we said that this low velocity zone is caused by the appearance of a bit of melt between the grains. The layer, all the rocks above the low velocity zone are defined as lithosphere. This is a kind of rigid lid on top of the softer low velocity zone. So this is the lithosphere, but we said that the lithosphere is composed of two layers. One is the lithospheric mantle, the other one is the crust. And we said that in terms of rock composition, the lithospheric mantle is similar to the composition of the asthenosphere. So it is part of the mantle, but the crust is very different, and this is why it's not part of the mantle. So we have the lithosphere is composed by crust and mantle, but the mantle is composed by asthenosphere and lithosphere. It's a bit tricky, but try to keep this in mind. The last point I want to mention is plate tectonics. This is the kind of scheme we've been using, and this is the scheme which you see in newspapers or in the media. It is characterized by the fact that we create the oceanic crust here in the ridge, and then the oceanic crust moves to the side, and the system goes down into the subduction zone. In principle, it's a machine which can continue forever, where nothing changes, nothing starts and nothing ends. This is what I call the Mickey Mouse plate tectonics, because it's not true. And like Mickey Mouse, nothing changes. The age of the actors remains the same and nothing changes. Now, there is at least two or three major phenomena in the Earth by which you can demonstrate, you can show that this is not true, that the picture is more complicated. And I want to show you two of these things and then I leave it to you. The first one is what you see in this picture, which is the East African Rift. This is the beginning of a new rift, which will possibly lead to a passive continental margin. This scheme is not present in my Mickey Mouse plate tectonics. Similarly, the second picture shows here the collision between two continents, like the Himalayas, like the Alps. Also, this situation is not present, is not feasible in the Mickey Mouse plate tectonics. I leave it to you to think about these things, and then in the course of the MOOC we can talk about. Thank you very much.